All right, praise God, praise God. Let me greet you all in Chinese. 各位弟兄平安，平安啊，弟兄姐妹啊，是吗？姐妹是啊，我的华文没有这样好啊，所以今天需要翻译员。OK，华语到此为止，我的华语。So thank you, Su Ping, for interpreting for me.
Thanks, Pastor Matthew. My privilege.
All right. Okay. So later we'll be praying for the sick.
待会儿呢，我们会为病痛的朋友祷告。
Yeah, this is not the first time I'm here.
这不是我第一次来到这里。
Yeah, this is I think the third time.
我想应该是第三次吧。
Yeah, and every time when we are here, we sense such a strong presence of God in this place.
每一次我们来到这里，能感受到这个神浓浓的这个同在。
Yeah, the favor of God is here.
神的恩宠就在这里。Okay,
if you are here today and you have a sickness in your body, we want to pray for you.
那如果你今天在这里，你身上呢有一些病痛，我们要为你祷告。And
we are serious about praying for you.
我们真的是非常的认真，我们要为你祷告。Yeah,
we really want to see you well.
我们真的希望看到你能够康复。So
later when we are praying, we are not just no blessing you, huh?
那我待会儿祷告的时候，我们不只是要祝福你而已。Yeah,
we want you to test your body.
我们要你去测试你的身体。Yeah,
if it's muscle pain or bone issues, you can test it out.
那如果这是你的肌肉的疼痛啊，或者是骨骼的疼痛呢，你可以去测试。Yeah,
if you don't test your body, you wouldn't know whether you are well.
如果你不去测试你的身体，你就不知道你到底有没有被医治。Okay,
so later when we pray for you, don't pansay,
huh? 所以等一下我们为大家祷告的时候，大家不要不好意思啊。
Yeah, if you are expecting God to move, then don't pansay, just do as what we tell you to do. Exercise, test your body and see whether the Lord has healed you.
所以如果你的期许呢，就是神他会大大的运作，他会医治你。那么在待会儿在祷告之后呢，大家要去测试你的身体。Okay,
let me start by sharing with you an amazing testimony that I saw.
那我先跟大家分享一个我看到的一个非常奇妙的见证。So
it was Easter Sunday and I was in a Methodist church.
这是复活节的那天，我在一个卫理公会的教会。Okay.
So during the time for prayer for healing, then suddenly there's a group of 10 people suddenly come out together like one gang, you know.
我们在进行医治祷告的时候呢，突然间有一组十个人，他们来到前面，一起走出来。
Yeah, so usually one big bunch all come out together quite scary lah.
有时这样一组人走上来，有点让人惊心动魄啊。Yeah,
then as I went to ask around, it turned out that only one person need prayer.
当我去问其他人的时候，我发现其实这十个人之中只有一个人需要祷告。
Yeah, so the other 9 people are her supporters.
其他九个人只是他的支持者。Very
nice, huh? So the whole cell group come out together to support the sister.
所以真的是非常美好，这整个关怀小组的成员呢，他们上来去支持他的这个姐妹。
Okay, so what happened to the sister? So the you know, this is some sort of arthritis in the finger.
这个姐妹呢，她是有这种手指的这个关节炎。
Yeah, so all the other fingers can open, but this one will get stuck.
她所有的这个手指都可以打开，就只有中间的这个中指没有办法打开。
Yeah, and whenever she tried to do it, it's very painful. She cannot get it straight.
她每次尝试要打开拉开这个手指呢，没有办法做到，因为这是很痛的一个过程。Okay.
Then okay, sister, come let me pray for you.
所以我就跟她说，姐妹，让我来为你祷告。Okay,
not simple, because the 9 people all surrounding her watching me.
这工作不简单，因为她另外9位团员呢都围绕着她看着我呢。
Very stressful,
非常压力非常大。
Okay, so after I pray in the name of Jesus, I break this arthritis. I command the fingers to open.
我就说，奉主耶稣祷告，我要破除这个关节炎。我命令这个手指必须伸直。Yeah,
then come the time for testing, right?
然后我们现在要测试了，对不对？
Okay, 1, 2, 3, open.
1, 2, 3，开。
打开，还是卡在那里，还是卡在那边。Okay, I'm like, okay, never mind. Let's pray one more time. In the name of Jesus, open.
那再祷告多一次，就是奉主耶稣名字打开。
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
哎呀, same 啊。
还是一样，没有办法。
Yeah, then I crack a joke. I say that, don't worry, I'm not Jesus.
我就开玩笑说，哎呀，不要担心了，我不是耶稣基督。
Even Jesus, when he prayed for the blind man, he need to play pray twice.
你们知道吗？耶稣基督他在为这个失明的这个盲人祷告，他也需要祷告两次。
And if I'm not Jesus, what do I do?
那如果我不是耶稣基督，我要怎么
？I pray three times.
我就祷告三次了。
Okay, so okay, come one more time, one more time.
我说好，再来一次，再来一次。
Okay, in the name of Jesus, I break the pain.
奉主耶稣的名，我们要破除这个疼痛。
In my mind, I'm thinking, well, better open.
我在心里想啊，这样赶快打开吧。
Okay, one, two, three, open.
一二三，打开。
Boom. 哎呦。It opened, eh?
真的打开了。
Okay, okay, okay. The privilege of having nine people surround you is that everybody go, wow!
所以你有九个人围在前面呢，它的好处就是每个人都在哇。
Yeah, one, two, three, say wow. One, two, three. Yeah, it's like surround sound, you know?
right? So
at that moment, I felt like, you know, I'm doing like a magic trick like that.
当时我感觉我好像在变魔术一样。
Yeah, but this is not a magic trick, my friends.
可是这个不是魔术。
Yeah, what we are doing here when we pray for you is more than a magic trick.
我们在这里呢，为大家祷告是超过这个魔术。
Yeah, you come for prayer with real emotions.
那我们来到这个祷告的时候呢，我们心中都有我们的真实的感受。
Yeah, when we pray for people, there are people who are crying one.
我们在祷告的时候，有些人他们会哭泣。
Because some sickness are so painful.
因为有些病痛呢，真的是非常的疼痛。
And you have carried that sickness for so long.
他们也一直有这个疼痛已经很长的时间了。
You think you come for a magic trick?
你觉得你是来看魔术的吗
？No, Jesus understands.
耶稣他真的了解到。
And his desire is to heal you.
那么他的渴望呢，就是他要医治你。
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, so later when we pray for you.Don't treat this as a magic trick, okay?
所以待会儿我们给大家祷告的时候，不要把它当成是这种魔术 ，okay?
We are serious.
我们是很认真的。
Yeah, you come serious before God.
我们到神面前，我们要很认真的。
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Praise God. Praise God. Okay. So today, before we pray for you, I want to talk about an elephant in the room.
那么今天呢，我们在祷告之前呢，我要谈到我们出会场中的这个象。大象
okay, because everybody have this question in their mind, but they don't dare to say it.
那每个人他们心中都有这个问题，可是他们不敢说出来。
Yeah, okay. The title of this message is "How much faith is enough?"
我们的这个主讲到的主题是多少信心才足够。
Yeah, all of us we know if we were to come before God, we need faith, right?
我们所有的人知道，如果我们要来到神面前，我们必须要有信心。
But how much faith is required exactly? Nobody.Knows.
到底我们需要多少的信心？没有人知道到底需要多少。
Yeah, yeah. So when I pray for people at the altar, for healing, I see a lot of different kind of expression on their faces.
所以我在祭坛为大家祷告的时候，我看到大家脸上的表情都不一样。
And most of the faces that I see, they are very stressful one.
多数人的表情呢，
very stressful faces,
都是很充满压力的那种表情。
Yeah, and they always look like this.
他们的样子往往都是这样子。
Yeah, I call this the cake side face. the toilet face, toilet face.
上厕所要挤你的
yeah,
做大号。
What are they doing? Right? Why? Because they are trying to have enough faith to receive something from God.
他们在做什么呢？其实他们是尝试要有足够的这个信心去接受这个医治。
So like a toothpaste, they're trying to squeeze out all the faith that they have to receive healing.
就好像这个你在挤牙膏的时候，你用尽全力呢，要把这个牙膏挤出来，就是这样子信心。
And I'm sure if you attend church long enough, there'll be somebody who actually tell you the reason that you are not healed is because you have not enough.
我相信呢，如果你在教会的时间相当长，应该是有人曾经告诉你说，你得不到医治，因为你的信心不够。
Is it correct?
是不是正确的
？Yeah. No. I mean, do you all hear this before?
你们听过吗？你们听过吗
？Yeah. I have good news for you today.
我今天有好消息。
Okay. I do not think that this is true.
我不觉得这是正确的。
Okay. I want to tell you exactly how much faith enough to approach God.
我要告诉你，到底你需要多少信心去寻求神。
And I'm going to share with you one of my favorite passages of scripture.
那给大家分享我一段我非常喜欢的经文。
Yeah. I believe that here Jesus make it very clear how much faith is needed to receive healing.
我相信通过这段经文呢，耶稣告诉我们非常清楚的告诉我们，我们到底需要多少信心。
Okay, and I'm sure you'll be very surprised.
我相信大家可能会感到相当的意外。
Okay, the passage for today is Mark chapter 2, verse 1 to 12.
那今天的这个经文是马可福音第二章一到十二节。
Okay. Okay. And the good news is you're not going to read everything.
好消息是我们不会全部都阅读、okay. 去读出来。
Oh, on the slide, on, hey, so fast put up the slide, relax. Okay, all right, later. Okay, I'm going to tell you the story, all right?
那给大家讲一个故事。
Okay, for those of us who are familiar, who have been church long enough, okay, you're familiar with this passage is about four men who brought their friends to Jesus through the roof.
那大家那些在教会待一阵子一段日子的这些人，你们可应该相当熟悉这段经文，就是说有四个人，他带着他一个朋友来见耶稣。
Familiar?
大家熟悉吗？
Yeah, let me retell the story, and I will highlight some of the insights that I have.
让我来重述这段故事这段经历，然后告诉你我的一些见解。
Okay, so in that passage, it was recorded that Jesus was in the hall.
那在这段经文呢，的记载就是说，耶稣他在一个is a hall?
Yeah, hall.
一个会所。
Okay, house or something. House.
一个家，一个人的家。
Okay, so in this house is packed with people.
那这个家呢是很多人，很拥挤的。
Yeah, by that time Jesus was already very famous.
当时呢，耶稣已经是非常的知名了。
Jesus was famous for healing the sick and casting out demons.
那他非常知名，因为呢，他医治病痛，他也赶鬼。
Yeah, and we were told that when Jesus was in that house, the house was packed with religious people.
那么我们这记载就说呢，当耶稣在那间屋子的时候呢，这屋子也有很多这些宗教的人士。
Yeah, people want to QC quality check. His teachings, huh?
那些人呢，他就要做这种质量检查，确保他教导的是正确的。
And those who really need a touch from Jesus, they are not able to come in.
可是那些真的需要耶稣的这个触动的，他们没有办法挤进去。
Yeah. So one of them is this paralyzed friend,
那其中一位就是在外面的这个瘫痪的朋友。
So this man is paralyzed. He had four friends, and the friends came up with a creative idea.
这个瘫痪的朋友他有四个，这个瘫痪的朋友他有四个朋友。那这四个朋友呢，他们就有一个非常有创意的一个想法。
Okay, they basically went up to the roof, make a hole, and lower the friend down.
他们就跑到这个天花板上，这个屋顶上，然后去挖了一个洞，把这个朋友抬下去。
And this takes a lot of faith. Can you imagine, Pastor? Right now, as I'm speaking, suddenly there's sound on going up there. Zigzag, zigzag, zigzag.
这真的是要很多的信心。你可以想象到吗？我现在在讲到这个上面呢，竟有这种 zigzag, zigzag 的声音在产生。
And then debris will start to drop down.
然后那些碎片就开始掉下来。
Okay, okay. Let me reenact this story. Then you follow with me. I'm going to talk about camera angle. Okay.
那我现在重讲这个故事，我会讲这个镜头的这个角度。
Okay, imagine.
Okay, 想象一下， imagine, 想象。
Okay, there's debris falling down.
这有碎片掉下来。
All right, and then, where is your eyes right now?
你的眼睛会在哪里啊？
Where's the camera angle?
那我们的这个镜头会放在哪个位置？
Looking up there, right? Like what's happening?
就可以对着上面，到底发生什么事情啊？
Yeah, should I call the police?
我是不是要叫警察了？
Yeah, does the person need to pay back the owner money?
这个人可能要偿还这个屋主的这个钱，修理的钱。
Yeah, I think need,
But, 我想应该要。
But the four friends, they never think of all these things.
可是四个朋友没有想到这一点。
Yeah, they are so desperate to get their friend to Jesus.
他们非常的急迫，他们要把他朋友交到放到这个耶稣的面前。
Okay, so suddenly a hole appeared.
突然间屋顶上有一个洞。
Yeah, your eyes are looking up there.
你的眼睛就看着上面。
Right? Okay, and then suddenly a hole appeared, and then four heads start to pop up.
然后这个洞出现了，然后有四个头就。大家都看到四个头在上面。
Okay, the camera angle is facing up, right?
所以你的镜头是对上的。
Now, then one man is being lowered down.
然后呢，有一个人被抬下来。
Where are you looking at?
那你会看什么？
Where are you looking at?
你会看着什么？
You're looking at who is the special man, right?
你会看到这个人到底是什么人？
Yeah? What happened to him, right?
到底他发生什么事情了？
Why are the friends up there so desperate to get this friend to Jesus?
为什么那四个朋友在上面呢？他们这么急迫要把这个人带到耶稣的面前呢？
Now I want us to read verse 5.
那现在我要大家去读第五节。
Verse 5.
第五节。
Okay, What is it? When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, Son, your sins are forgiven.
耶稣看见他们的信心, 就对摊子, 就是这个瘫痪的人说, 孩子, 你的罪被赦免了。
Yeah, and we know that later on, he went to heal that man.
我们知道过后呢, 耶稣就去医治这个人。
Now, notice the camera angle. The camera angle is on the man, right?
那现在我们的镜头是对着这个人，对不对？
Let me ask you a question right now.
我现在来问大家一个问题。
Okay. Whose faith was it that moved Jesus? Whose faith was it that moved Jesus?
到底是谁的信心打动了耶稣？
Who is it?
是谁？
The four friends, right?
这四个朋友对吗？
Remember the camera angle I tell you to...
记得那个镜头吗？
Yeah? The Bible could have easily recorded that Jesus saw his faith.
圣经它可以说耶稣看到的是他的信心。
Yeah? But the Bible recorded that as Jesus saw their faith.
可是这个圣经记载的是耶稣看到的是他们的信心。
Yeah? Okay, so depending on the camera angle that you have, it can be all five together, their faith, or the four men.
所以这取决于你的这个镜头，可能是这五个人的这个信心，或者是这四个人。What
impressed Jesus was not only the faith of that paralyzed man.
那打动了耶稣的心的，不是不只是那个瘫痪的人的这个信心。
Okay, I don't know whether you have seen people who are very seriously paralyzed.
不知道大家有没有看过，就是瘫痪的很严重的人。Yeah,
I prayed for many of these cases before.
我过去呢曾经为这些病例祷告过。Yeah,
my father has also prayed for many of these people.
我的父亲也为这些人祷告过。Yeah,
those who are very seriously paralyzed, right? They cannot think one.
那些瘫痪的非常严重的人呢，其实他们的思路是很不清晰的。
Yeah, they just stare in the sky, stare ahead at you. They are not thinking one.
他们不会在思考，他们只是这样子迷茫的这样望着天空这样子。
Yeah, yeah, and to be for that four men to be so desperate to bring their friend to Jesus to destroy someone's house, it must be because that friend is very seriously paralyzed.
所以这四个朋友啊，他们那么急迫，他们去。 挖开那个屋顶，一个洞，把这个朋友交到这个耶稣面前。这个人的这个瘫痪程度应该是非常严重的。
How can that paralyzed man have faith?
那这个瘫痪的人怎么可能会有信心呢？
So interestingly, we also see such situations happen in the healing room ministry in Singapore, where we minister.
所以我们在进行医治事工的时候，我们看到在医治祷告的这个会所呢，有这样子的现象。
Christians. Right? Basically brought their family and loved ones to the healing ministry.
基督徒呢, 他们就带了他们的亲朋好友, 亲朋戚友来到, 这个祷告会。
And some of their family members, they are not Christians, you know?
那有些家人呢, 他们是非信徒。
And non-Christians can receive big healings.
那非信徒, 他们也可以得到很大的医治。
Yeah, you do not need to receive Jesus into your heart and be a Christian before Jesus can touch you.
那你其实不需要接受耶稣。 耶稣成为你的主，耶稣才会去触动你。
Amen. Yeah, faith is not complicated.
所以信心其实一点都不复杂。
The fact is this, that God wants to touch us so much that it does not matter if we have big faith or small faith.
实际的情况是呢, 神真的希望能够打动我们的心, 所以不管我们的信心是大是小，这是重要的。
Just bring yourself to Jesus or bring someone to Jesus, this is enough.
你只需要把自己或者是一个人带到耶稣面前， 这就足够了。
Okay, I want to show you a photo.
要给大家看一张照片。
Okay, this is can be a small gross, a little bit gross. Okay,
okay.
So I call this young man my small iron man.
这个是我叫他我的小铁人。小铁人，铁人。
Okay, so this boy, this is in India, right? This is India.
这在印度。
And during the pandemic time, where we minister, where we pray for the sick over Zoom.
当时是疫情期间，我们是通过 Zoom 来为病痛的人祷告。
So this boy from birth he has this growth in the chest.
这个男孩呢，他从出生以来呢，他的这个胸口就有这个肿块。Yeah,
so whenever he wear a shirt, they cannot button on, you know.
所以他在 it's popping out. 他穿衣服的时候，他是没有办法把它扣起来的。
Yeah, it's really like Iron Man. It's really like Iron Man.
真的是好像。
So after the Zoom meeting, I received a photo. One day after the healing meeting, the growth start to go down.
我们的这个 Zoom 的这个会议结束之后， 隔天我们收到这个照片，它的这个肿块呢已经缩小了。
Yeah, and after 7 days, apparently they sent me this photo where he can button his shirt now.
七天之后呢，他们给我这张照片，他的这个衣服呢能够扣上纽扣了。
I don't know why they don't send me a shirtless picture, but this will suffice. I cannot contact them anymore.
Okay.
Let's continue to show the photo again. Okay. So I want to tell you something amazing about this event, because during the Zoom meeting, right? Okay, you know, in India, I think Philippines as well, the families, they like to all squeeze in one room.
那么我要告诉大家，这个 Zoom 的会议它有相当奇妙的事情发生。
Yeah.
那么他们这个在印度，它跟菲律宾也是一样，他们很喜欢很多人挤在一间小房间。
Yeah, because they want to share the aircon.
因为他们要一起共用那个冷气。
Okay, so we were having the Zoom meeting and we didn't even pray for the boy.
那么我们当时呢在进行这个 Zoom 的会议，我们没有特地为这个小孩祷告。
Yeah. In fact, the boy don't even want prayer one.
其实这个男孩呢，他根本不想接受祷告。
That boy was just sitting at the corner of the room playing mobile game.
那当时这个男孩呢，他是在一个角落在玩他的电玩。
He didn't want healing.
他不要得到医治。
Yeah, he didn't even ask for healing.
他也没有要求要得到医治。
But Jesus touched him.
可是耶稣还是触动了他。
Amen.Amen. Yeah, let's take away this photo.
Okay, 我们先。
Okay, I want to. This is the camera, right? Okay. For those of you who are watching online.
那些在线上观看的朋友。
Yeah, I don't know whether you are paying attention.
我不知道你有没有注意听。
Yeah, and maybe for those of us here today, some of you are.You are a domestic helper, and you are bringing your employers to the service.
那可能我们在现场有些是帮佣，你可能带你的雇主来到这里。
And some of the young people, you may be playing mobile games right now.
那我看到可能年轻人，你们现在在玩电玩。
Yeah, Jesus can touch you.
耶稣还是可以触动到你。
Jesus sees you.
他还是看到你的。
And he desires to touch you today.
他的渴望是能够触动你。
Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, we have a lot of domestic helpers who actually bring their employers to the service, but the domestic helper got healed.
那我们其实很多这个帮佣啊，他们过去带了他们的雇主来到我们的医治特会，结果呢是帮佣他们自己本身得到医治。
Amen? Amen. So you qualify, all right?
所以你绝对符合资格。
Amen. All right. Just come to Jesus. This is enough.
你只需要来到耶稣面前，这就足够了。
Amen. Okay, so I want to share with you 3 instances where Jesus actually tell people that their faith has healed them.
那我要告诉大家三个例子。那耶稣呢，在这三个例子的告诉这些人，说他们的信心就足够医治他们了。
Yeah, the first one is Mark chapter 5, verse 34.
第一个是取自这个马可福音第五章三十四节。
We are familiar with this passage. Okay, this passage is about the woman with the issue of blood.
大家应该熟悉这段经文，这个是有一个妇女，她有这个血漏病的情况。
Okay, at that time, it is taboo. Okay, this when the lady is having the time of the month, you are considered unclean. You are supposed to stay home, don't interact with anyone.
在当时呢，如果女生她们有这个就是经期的期间呢，你必须要留在家中，她们不能出来见人的，这是一个禁忌。
But, so this lady has been bleeding for a long time.
那这个妇女呢，她流血已经是很长
时间了。She wants healing, and Jesus is in town.
那她要得到医治，而耶稣就在这个城市
里面。It does not care what everyone thinks. Crawl under the feet of people just to touch the robes of Jesus.
她不管别人怎么想，她就这样钻在人群之中，爬到这个耶稣的旁边去触摸他的这个外袍。
And she was healed.
然后她就被医治了。
And Jesus said to her.
那耶稣就跟她说
，Daughter。Your faith has healed you.
他就说，女儿，你的信心救了你，你的病好了。
Okay, next one. Okay, Luke chapter 17, verse 19.
下一个例子呢，是来自路加福音十七章。
This is about the 10 lepers.
这是关于十个麻风病人。
10 of them got healed, but only one of them came back to Jesus.
那十个麻风病人他都被医治，可是只有一个人回来答谢耶稣。
Right, Jesus said to him, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well."
那耶稣就告诉这个人说，起来回去吧，你的信心救了你。
Interesting, yeah.
这很有意思啊。
Okay, the third one.
第三个例子。
Matthew chapter 8 verse 8.
是马太福音第八章第八节。
Yeah, this is about the Roman centurion who told Jesus to pray from a distance.
这个是关于这个罗马的百夫长，他叫耶稣从一段距离去远程的这种方式来祷告。
Yeah, this was way before Zoom was invented.
这个是在 Zoom 产生之前。
Okay, no Wi-Fi.
没有 Wi-Fi.
But this man has so much faith to ask Jesus, Jesus, don't need to come to my house. Just pray where you are. My servant will get healed.
他就说呢，他的这个信心是这么强，他就跟耶稣说，你不需要来到我的家，你只需要在这里祷告，我的仆人就会被医好。
Yeah. So when Jesus prayed and that centurion left,
当耶稣祷告，然后这个百夫长离开之后，
Yeah. Jesus turned and said to his disciples, "Wow."
然后耶稣就转向他的这个门徒跟他们说 wow,
yeah, Truly I tell you I have not found anyone in Israel with that great faith
他说我实在告诉你们我在以色列从未见过信心这么大的人
yeah, yeah, That Roman centurion is a Gentile
这个罗马的这个百夫长呢他是一个外邦人
yeah, That Gentile have more faith than all the Jews combined
那这个外邦人呢竟然比所有的这些犹太人集合起来的这个信心还要大
Now these three instances
这三个例子
yeah, What is the common trait?
我们看到的共同点是什么
What is the common trait? I ask you right now
它的共同点是什么
What is it? Yeah?Yeah. Okay. These people, they just come to Jesus.
这些人，他们就是来到耶稣面前。
Yeah. This is the definition of simple faith.
这个就是单纯的信心的例子。
We have the slide, right? Yeah. Just come to Jesus.
你只需要来到。
Just bring someone to Jesus.
你只需要来到耶稣面前，你只需要把人带到耶稣面前，这就够了。
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Simple faith.
是单纯的信心。
How much faith is enough?
多少的信心才足够？
Just come to Jesus.
只要来到耶稣。
Just bring someone to Jesus.
把人带到耶稣面前。
And this will be enough.
这就足够了。
Okay, no need stress, no need toilet face.
不需要很压力，不需要好像在上厕所这样。
Just relax.
只要放轻松。
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so now we see one more interesting thing.
那我们看到另外一个很有趣的现象。
Okay, can we have the Mark chapter 2 verse 5?
我们看马可福音第二章第五节
yeah, Jesus not only healed that man's body
那耶稣不只是医治了那个人的身体
Jesus also forgave that man's sin
他也赦免了这个人的罪
True someone else's faith
通过其他的人的信心
I don't know about you but when I read this my mind is like huh?
我不知道你怎么想当我在读这段经文的时候我真的是 huh?
Yeah, I mean, okay, healing that man's body, I can understand.
那我可以理解耶稣医治这个人的身体。
But forgiving that man's sin through another person.
可是通过另外一个人去赦免这个人的罪。
Shouldn't we need to first repent?
难道我们不是应该先自己悔改吗？
Correct.
对不对
Yeah, do you have the same question? I have the same question. I have that question.
同样问题，我有这样的问题。
And the Lord reminded me.
那主提醒了我。
Yeah.This thing called extravagant love.
这个我们称为奢侈的爱。
Yeah, and what I mean is that Jesus loves us extra.
我的意思就是说呢，耶稣他是加倍的爱着我们。
Yeah, even when we do not deserve it, Jesus, God first sent His Son Jesus to die for our sins.
那即使我们不配得，神他还是派遣了他的儿子来为我们的罪而死。
And when I look at things from this angle, then I understand.
当我从这个角度看，那我就理解了。
Okay, Pastor, this.Will be a very powerful illustration, but a bit NC-16 lah, a bit NC-16 lah. So I will talk in some code words. If you understand, you understand. Okay.
Yeah. 所以这个是比较特别的一个例子啊。那么其实是不适宜16岁以下的人，所以我会用一些比较婉转的一些词。
Don't explain to them, huh?
你们不要给十六岁以下的人解释啊。
You know, when I was praying for the sick in Vietnam.
我在越南为病痛的朋友祷告。
There was one service I remember that service.
我记得有一次的这个特会，祷告特会。
Yeah, we were like this hall. We were praying later when we call the sick to come, and many people come.
那就像这个会场一样，我们过后呢会请那些有病痛的人来到前面。
And we are praying for the sick. We are very busy.
然后我们就很忙碌的为各个病痛的人
祷告。Then there was one big man that come. You know those people who work out in the gym. Those muscular men.
那有一个肌肉非常健壮的个子非常大的一个男子，他就走前来了。
Yeah, he walked up to me and asked for prayer.
他走到我面前，然后要求我祷告。
I don't understand Vietnamese.
我不明白越南语。
So she speaks to my interpreter, and my interpreter was female. Is female.
那么我的他就跟我的翻译员讲话。那么我的翻译员是个女性。
Yeah, and my interpreter hear the prayer request. After she heard the prayer request, her face turned red.
那他这个翻译员，他听了这个祷告要求之后呢，他的整个脸都通红了。
And she looked at me and said, "Pastor, this one I don't know how to interpret."
他就跟牧师说，牧师啊，这个我不知道要怎么祷告，要怎么祷告。
So she took out her phone and then she started to type and then she showed me Google Translate.
然后他就输入他用他电话输入，然后用这个谷歌来翻译。
When I read the screen,
当我在看他的屏幕的时候
，it says butthole pain. 你脸红啊。And then he also asked for prayer requests for HIV.
他也要求为他的艾滋病病毒祷告。
And when I look at the man,
当我看着这个男人
the actions also a bit effeminate.
他的这个动作有点女性化。
Yeah, and then I was like, I understand.
好，我就说啊，我明白了，我明白了。
So I look at him and I ask him, have you repented of your sins?
我看着他，我就问他，你是否为你的罪悔改？
He said, yes, Pastor, I gave my life to Jesus just now at the altar call.
他说是的，牧师，刚才在祭坛呼召的时候呢，我已经把我的生命交给耶稣了。
And I say, okay, let me pray for you.
好的，我就为你祷告。
After I pray for you, you go to the toilet and test.
那么你我祷告之后呢，你去厕所去测试一下。
Yeah, HIV, you go and do a blood test.
那这个艾滋病呢，你要去做验血。
So after I pray for him, he went to the toilet.
那我在为他祷告之后，他到厕所去了。
And I continue to pray for everybody else.
那我继续为其他人祷告。
15 minutes later, he come back.
15分钟之后，他回来了。
He say, Pastor.
他就说：“牧师啊，牧师
，pain no more，
没有痛了。
”Hallelujah, praise God, praise God. Okay, okay, you can, okay, okay. We don't clap so fast. Later I tell you when to clap.
我们先说鼓掌啊，我待会告诉你原因。
Okay, so a few days later, I got a message from him on Facebook.
那几天后呢，我在 Facebook 收到了他的一条信息。
Pastor, HIV negative.
他就说：“牧师啊，我的艾滋病已经是阴性了。”
Not yet, not yet.
还没有，还没有。
Okay.
稍等，稍等。
And he said, Pastor, are you free for coffee?
他就问我说：“牧师啊，你有没有空喝咖啡
？”Because my friends want to meet you as well.
因为我的朋友也要见你。
Yeah. Okay. So we set a date and we met up for coffee.
我们就约好了日子，我们就见面喝咖啡。
At the cafe,
在咖啡厅的时候呢
，there is four people, all kinds, the spectrum is there.
有四个人，各种的，
yeah,
各种各。
Gay, lesbian, straight, bisexual, the whole spectrum.
有男同性恋、女同性恋、双性恋的人都有。
And all of them they want prayer.
他们所有的人都需要祷告。
As I prayed for them one by one, their pain and left one by one.
那我逐一的为他们祷告，他们的疼痛就消失了。
Yeah, there's one of them cannot sleep for 6 months.
有一个人呢，他六个月没有办法睡觉。
It's a lady.
她是个女的。
Yeah, if she remove her makeup, wow, the eye bag very big one.
如果她洗掉她的这个化妆呢，她的这个黑眼圈非常的严重。
Yeah, that night she had the best sleep of her life.
那天晚上呢，她睡得非常的香甜。
And you know when I was praying for them and they're getting healed and they're crying.
当我为他们祷告，他们得医治之后呢，他们都在哭泣。
And they are all telling me that, Pastor, we did so many wrong things, but yet God healed us.
他们就说 ，Yes, 牧师啊，我们做了这么多错事，尽管如此呢，耶稣基督还是医治了我们。
And suddenly I had an inspiration, and I said back to them.
突然间呢，我就有个启发，我就告诉他们说
，Not just heal you.
不只是医治你。
Jesus forgives you of your sins.
耶稣也宽恕了你的罪。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now you can clap. Hallelujah. Let's praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
感谢耶稣，感谢耶稣。
You know, to close my message, I want to talk about the Father heart of God.
那在总结的时候呢，我要跟大家谈我们神他有这个天父的爱。
You know all these healing things that take place, it actually showcases the Father heart of God.
那我们这些医治的这些情况呢，其实它就体现了我们天父的爱。
How many of you are parents here?
谁是家长在座各位？
Yeah.
有谁是家长？
Let me ask you, if your children is hungry.
那我要问你，如果你的孩子他肚子饿了，
and you prepare food for them,
那你为他们准备食物，
do you prepare just enough?
你是不是准备刚刚好足够他们吃？
Not really, right?
不会，对吗？
Yeah, you prepare more than enough.
你会多准备一些。
Yeah, why?
为什么呢？
Because if your children gets hungry again, or their appetite, they on turbo, they very hungry, yeah, they got more.
因为如果他们又肚子饿了，因为他们胃口非常好，他们还有食物吃。
Correct or not?
对吧？
Correct? Yeah? Okay, I got no children.
我自己本身没有孩子。
But if I got children, this is what I would do.
那如果我有孩子，我也会这么做的。
Okay? And I believe that this is a reflection of the Father heart of God.
我相信这就体现了我们神父神的这个爱，他的心。
Yeah?Yeah, there is always more in the kingdom of God.
那在上帝的国度里，总是会有更多的。
Yeah, if you want healing, Jesus has it.
如果你要医治，耶稣基督有。
Now, okay, if you know that God has healing and maybe more than just the healing, what would you do?
那如果你知道，神他有，他能够给你医治，而且可以给你更多，你会怎么做？
What would you do?
你会怎么做呢？
Yeah, I will.Be more daring.
那我会更加的大胆。
I will ask for more.
我会跟他要更多。
Amen or not?
对吗？
Yeah. I think I said this before. There was one time I was in the church. One lady come and ask for prayer.
我曾经说过这件事，就是我在教会有一个女子，她就走上来要求祷告。
And say, Pastor, can you help me pray for the doctors to have the wisdom to give me the right medication?
她就说呢，牧师啊，请你为我的医生祷告，让他们有这个智慧，能够给我对的、正确的这个的药物。
No, don't ask for this kind of prayer request.
我说不要这样子问。
Yeah, if you want medication, you go to the hospital.
那如果你要药的话，去医院就可以了。
But if you want a miracle,
如果你要奇迹
，come to Jesus.
来到耶稣面前。
Now that you are in the church,
那你现在在教会里
，might as well ask for a miracle, right?
那你应该要求神迹奇事。
Amen or not?
对吗
？Yeah,、
Amen.
Do you need to?Make appointment to come here?
需要预约吗？
你得take the sheet. Number no need.
拿号码吗？不用啊。
Jesus loves you.
耶稣爱你。
And his desire is to give you more.
他的渴望是能够给你加倍的多。
You know, we are going to pray for the sick later.
我们待会呢会为病痛的朋友祷告。
And I want to let you know that before we start praying, that there is a blessing that is better than healing.
那我要告诉你，在我们祷告之前，告诉你，我们除了这个医治的这个祝福呢，我们有更好的东西要给你。
You know, no matter how big the healing that you receive, one day all of us will pass on.
那不管我们得到的医治有多大，有一天呢，
yeah?
我们都会离开这个世界。
Yeah, because this is just human life,
因为人就是这样子，
okay,
我们的生命
长生不老immortality is not real
长生不老这是不真实的。
Yeah, but healing happens today because Jesus wants to give you a taste of what heaven is like.
我们之所以会得到医治，是因为耶稣他要你去感受到在天国是怎么样的一个情况。
And the biggest blessing is.Like what Jesus gave to the man, not just heal the person, but forgive him of his sins.
所以最大的祝福呢，就像刚才我们讲的这个经文，耶稣医治了这个人，不只是医治他，而是宽恕了他的罪。
Okay, I don't know if there's any one of us who are here and you're not a Christian.
那我不知道在现场，有没有人是你不是基督徒
？Yeah, maybe you have come to church. for a long time, but you have not given your life to Jesus, your heart to Jesus.
可能你来教会已经很长的时间，你还没有把你的心交给耶稣基督。
I know. I've seen some people who attend the church week after week, but they're not Christian. Have.
我知道，我看过有些人呢，他们一直每一个星期都去教会，可是他们并没有把他们的心交给耶稣。
Can I have the worship team out?
我们请我们的敬拜团队到台上来。Yeah.
Today, before we start praying for the sick, I want to give us a chance.
那今天我们在为病痛的朋友祷告之前，我要给大家一个机会。
Okay, to receive the biggest blessing that Jesus can offer.
去接受耶稣基督可以给我们的最大的祝福。
That next time when we pass on, we know where we are going.
那我们知道呢，当我们离开这个世界的时候呢，我们知道我们会去到哪里。
That we will be in heaven.
我们会在天上。
Amen.
Amen.
Some of you may be thinking, oh, if I go to heaven and my loved one is not there, how?
那有的人会想说，如果我上了天堂，我的家人都没有上天堂，那怎么办呢？
Don't worry so much.
不用担心。
Yeah, your loved ones will want you to be in heaven.
那么你的家人呢，他们会要你上天堂。
And better still, your loved ones, if your family is here, the whole family come to Jesus together.
那更好的是，当你的家人如果他们在现场的话，他们全家人都去接受耶稣基督。
For those of you who are watching online and you feel a strange tugging in your heart.
那在线上观看的朋友，可能你觉得你心上有点在搅动的感觉。
This is not because I talk very well, you know.
这个不是因为我讲得很好。
Yeah, this is because the Holy Spirit is where you are.
那因为圣灵就与你同在。
And Jesus loves you.
耶稣爱你。
And more than just the healing, Jesus wants you to receive salvation.
耶稣不只是要你得医治，他要你得救恩。
Yeah, Jesus wants to see you in heaven.
那耶稣要在天上看到你。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Can I ask for all of us to close our eyes?
我们请大家闭上眼睛。